the Jiu-Jitsu in Arizona is great. I actually think it's unique in the sense that we're really, truly one big community. I'm just assuming, but I think we're one of the few states in the country that cross-trains as much as we do. I mean, every school, you know, we're always cross-training at different gyms, going to different open mats. So we're one big community. Even though we're from different teams, different associations, we're still one big family and always training together and for one goal, and to make jiu-jitsu better for everyone. I would say this, our style of training is both jiu-jitsu and also very wrestling based. I take a lot of the training style and the programming from wrestling and try to apply it into jiu-jitsu. Like we don't just do like open mats at the end of class. There's a very specific goal we have for our training, and we do a lot more positional and situational work in our sparring than we actually do free sparring or free rolls. So it gives our students an opportunity to be able to actually utilize what we worked on that night or day against a resisting opponent. And it's one thing to do it against someone that's just letting you do it, and when you do it against someone that's resisting. And the situational or positional sparring basically gives you more opportunities to try out that move that we used at night as often as you can, because if we, in just an open mat, you might just hit it once or twice, you know, but with the situational sparring, you have more opportunities and chances to utilize a technique. So, next goal is obviously, it's gonna be to do well, okay? And I wanna have the numbers, we're gonna have the numbers, but I wanna win and do well on quality, not quantity. I don't want to just bring a big army and just get a bunch of, you know, points because of they just got lucky and got it. I want them, the goal is to win on quality points, not just by default.